So first of all, sorry for that slight delay. You see, it's like 22 now. We delayed it partly because there was a last minute change in venue. So originally, we were supposed to be in Oxford Street, Oxford Circus, at Westminster University. And then we were supposed to be here. But even though some people got that information, some people have gone to, like, there's a downstairs basement area on the road. So there are a few people down there. And we can't really, we have to make it on the gallery show. So my name is Tony Warren. I'm from a group called Black History Walks. We organize walking tours of London's African history and important films and important presentations. Today's presentation is titled Sisters in Science Fiction. It's looking at women in science fiction, in print, in cartoons, in films, in media. And we're going to hear from two different speakers. The first speaker is a woman called Felisha Mason. And then the second speaker is a woman called Tosin Coker. Tosin's on the way, she's from the day, she'll be here shortly. Felisha Mason is one of the creators of a franchise called All Knightz. AllKnightz.com. So if you look over there, you see there's a big post and some comics and some magazines and some art. So Felicia's a main creator in the All Knightz universe, and she's an artist, and she's a writer, and she's a creator and a business guru. The way the format's going to work for this presentation, which by the way is one of 12. So this is the first of 12 events looking at women in science fiction. Apart from this one, the next one we're planning to have is looking at women in science fiction on TV. The person doing that, she was supposed to do it about a month ago, but then she got ill. So when she gets better, I'm soon back to kind of full strength. We're going to have that presentation. So she's been looking at about 40 years of women in science fiction on television. So there's a whole bunch of stuff there. But as far as today's concerned, we're here from Felisha first of all for about 45 minutes or so. Then there'll be some time for some questions of her. She'll show you some examples of her work and also show you some of what's coming up, because some people are going from drawing static books into what they call motion comics. So she has examples of that. So first part will be Felisha Mason about her work and how she got to her work and what she's doing now in the future. Then we'll have a Q&A. Then we'll have a little break. And then our second speaker is Tosin Coker. And Tosin Coker is a novelist. So she's written about 8 different books on science fiction so far. And she's published children's books in Yoruba. So she actually published books in the African language. So we'll hear from both those speakers. But our first speaker is going to be Felisha Mason. So please give it up for Felisha Mason.
But I would say, okay, right, I'm going to do the writing part now. And it sometimes I could be sitting down listening to a Transformer soundtrack and it would just flow. That's, everyone gets inspired in different ways. So I started doing that writing, and then we got the concept idea about being in London. So he's a man that has a son. His son gets killed due to mistaken identity. And then as a result of that, you know, as any parent, he ends up kind of going downhill. It ends up turning a different way. But then he starts learning that. He starts seeing his son, and he's like, well, I'm seeing my son, and his son's a spirit. And his son gives him powers, and after that, he's like, he ends up just trying to take down whoever killed his son. But on along that mission, you end up learning about the characters. So you've got the program then running out of him. So he's going to take them down no matter what. So it's just so many factors involved in it and the plots, and I just got so excited. You know what? I said, yeah, I'm going to do this. And I did it. I did it. And here I am, 10 issues in now. Never thought I'd have a comic. Didn't. Never thought that's what I'd be doing. So yeah, so done issue one, and the process, it makes you kind of appreciate comics now. So when I go into Forbidden Planet and I buy that £1 comic, I appreciate it because you kind of realise what it takes to make a comic. Knightz alone, one comic costs £2.5 grand. It's not cheap. If you want the quality, you can go ahead and do it. Now, obviously, All Knightz is the main, you know, that's the foundation. There's 5 directors, and I'm one of them. Now, each director has their own comics. So, you know, mine is Knightz, so you have Ron Riley, who has Hard Riley, Ron Lynch, and you have Jason C. Yuki, who has K-9 Kings, and then you've got Jesse. So, we'll also have their own comics that's coming out in the future. So, we start to say, okay, right, we've all got our ideas, let's get up to the process of it. When you start to do a comic, the first part is writing. So you've done your script, you've done all of that, you've plotted it how you want it to be done. The next part, so and then also I'm going to say everyone in the team has their roles, so that helps. So then, after you've done the writing, and you've panelled it all up, you then go on to the panel designs. So what that would be is say panel one would say have Knightz on fighting, so you don't have to draw that panel. Just being rough with the company, looking at artists, the anyone you know, you just have to do a rough. So you'll do that for each panel, and when I say panels, I mean like that. So these things are classed as panels. You can see here. Or if you've got those on a page. So that's some images of that. So do you see here? These are what you call panels. So obviously that's the end result. But before then, it's just a sketch, just a white paper. That's it. But you do each panel by itself separately. Okay? So you've done that part now. So then after you've done that for the whole comic, depending on how many pages you have, might be 24 pages, sometimes it goes up to about 26. So after you've done that for all those pages, you then say, right, you go on to artists who you know you may apply to help do that. So for me it was Jarvis Cruz. He's basically a very talented guy. So Jarvis has then done all that art to make it look how you see it there. So it looks cool. He looks basically looks good. He makes it look how it should look on the comic. So he's done that, and then you then go to the colourist. That's when you get the finished end. So all you have is just a plain sheet, no writing, just the colourist. Any result is that. Then they come back to us, and then we then go on to lettering. And once you do the lettering, so that's going through each part of the comic, making sure the script runs with each panel, making sure the script works and flows right. It has to flow right. If it doesn't, people won't get it. So some people may read, I don't know, so left to right, right, so it has to read in a way that everyone can flow and it gets where it's going, so you understand where the story is going. You don't go to a page and be like, what's this? I don't understand what's happening. People can get lost easily. So you have to make it flow. Now after you've done that, you literally go to the printers. That is the process. The process can be quite daunting sometimes. As I said, that's all. It was £2.5 grand to make. So even though I've gone through the whole process of doing it, I appreciate it a lot, especially doing comics. I appreciate it a lot. I didn't know that before. And then being a woman in the industry, there are some, but there's not a lot of women. comics. And yeah, like I said, I'm you know, 2 issues in now. Already the third one's finished, so we're going to go to that next. And then there will be things like obviously animation, because of course we all want to see animation, that's a must. But yeah, that is pretty much what I do and what I have done. I'm very proud of it. think it's definitely a story of people in their life from a while to while. If you like action, if you like thriller, if you, you know, you just want to see people get, you know what I'm saying?
It's something you need to understand.
learn a little extra stuff because it ends up helping. That's when I started getting questioned. That's when I said, right, I'll be a wisdom woman with this. That's when I said, right, I'm going to own something with this. And I did. So you have to learn about, learn from people. And the thing is, don't be afraid to fail or make a mistake. It's not, it's really not a big thing. Like, oh, learn from it. It is what it is. You're going to make mistakes in everything you do. I'm not perfect. Like, you know, one time I got things wrong, like in the comic, don't worry about it. Get up, move on, keep going. So that's how I started doing that. And maybe we'll never do it because you're right now. The budget promotion, like, actually, that was done through Just the Soul, so it wasn't ready for that budget. But original motion of it, ending that. Yeah, there isn't, because I wish there was, but it could be from small to quite a big amount to do a motion of it. So it's not cheap, but it's not.
It depends on the assets that you may or may not have. If you've got a lot of the pre-production assets, it becomes cheaper. But if you don't, then you've got to do it with the scrap. It's more fun. So it really depends. And it depends how long you want to be as well.
So that was the kind of awesome. The soundtrack was done by Cotty.
Yeah, it's a dubstep.
It is a dubstep, right? So, yeah, Cotty done a track for us. So, yeah, fun. No, maybe. No, maybe pay for that. But,
might be a bit boring. I'm just asking about money thing again.
I'm not saying number one, if you're going to do a gate one, gate one, we prefer to do that on our back pocket. We just do. And so no, we haven't had any grants like that, but we just do it ourselves. Hello?
Hi. Have you got any many shops?
At the moment, we've got a few shops. I know we've got some East London, we've got some in Brixton. Knightz have got to be a gate picture because we started out with Hardwired first. So when the time Knightz came out, Hardwired's already all in the shop. So my one hasn't been there yet, but our one will be online. You can find us at events like this as well. So you probably actually didn't get to see me as well. You know what? We've actually stopped doing comic book for a while. I'm going to tell you why. We used to do comic book. We did a UK tour. We went to Cardiff, we went to Birmingham. Many these are our characters. So if I want to make my character whatever, it's up to me. So I think like the more powerful as well your characters, you are your characters, the more people will be like, they'll be like, punch it. Like, no, I like what you're doing, I see what you're doing. There may be people in here that might say, oh, I don't know how to do comics. And they might see me and say, no, well, she can do it, I can do it too. You damn right you can. There's no reason why you can't do it. I can't do it. You know what I mean? Just be creative, that's what I have to say. And it's
How's the demand in Africa and the Caribbean for your characters?
The thing is, there's quite a bit of in Africa, so you know quite a few people over there. Jamaica or in the Caribbean, I would say, not really up to that. I think it's going to have a really big out there to promote it, but I think if we did, I think we would probably get there. I think they would like it because it's something new, something different. And I don't think they've really seen that. And I know there's quite a few artists as well in Jamaica or in the Caribbean. But again, a lot of them are quite silent, right? Which I think is bad, just kind of get yourself out. So,
yeah. Have you managed to make that money out of
the
spring
town?
Huh?
That's me, it's even though it comes out, you know, like I said, each comic is different prices, so mine's 2.5 grand, mine's different, everyone's comic is different. But you do end up making your money back. But remember, you don't always see it straight away. That's what people need to understand when it comes to a business. So what you may put out first, we're going to get that straight away. It's what people need to understand when it comes to businesses. If you have a business, that's fine. If you have a great idea, that's fine. Your stuff will sell, that's fine. What you may be buying your merchandise, paying an artist. You know, I mean, I'm a colourist, so the pens that I use are like, you know, there's 12 pens in, I use topics, so there's 12 pens in it. And that's 63 pounds. Mm-hmm. Do you see what I'm saying? So, but you have to spend on yourself. You have to spend to invest in yourself. So you have to. But yeah, you do get the money back. But later on, it's not going to come straight away. And again, marketing. If you don't market yourself, who are you going to know you are? No, you won't know you are. So you have to market yourself. So you obviously got a Facebook and obviously Instagram, Twitter. Us being at events like this, and even we're looking at like market stores and stuff, so we're pretty much all over the place, and I think that's what helps you out. Even us like wearing a t-shirt, I can't remember the last time I bought something like that. I can't. I wear this to brand new. So I mean, even though I've changed it all night, see? So it's brand new. I'm just walking around in this, but me walking around in this, so I might see, I remember I went to the Natural History Museum. And then he was like, oh, I remember you. You was at the black market even because I was wearing this. So I'm saying, so that's another way of branding. Yes, so. It wouldn't really be a difference because we're kind of doing it now. We are doing it now. So it's pretty much when you have the content, that's what helps. So it makes it easier. Don't have anything, it'll be very hard to do it. But because you've got all the artwork, we've got all the character designs, you can do that. Like, I learned from way of doing that, like, even a run sequence, it takes, it was eight pictures, and that's just doing that. So for each eight pictures, it has to be a different movement, and that's just called a run sequence. So it's like you can easily go from this to that animation. As long as you have the content to do it. Well, I would. The thing is, you say that because we've got, I think, as I said, Bradley Lewis, who's in America, he's got a game of verses that's coming out. And my character, one of the ninjas, will still see them. So, woman, remember what we said there, one of the women, he's like, you know, the ninja twins is going to be in it. And one of the women's characters, is it Bradley Lewis?
Isis.
There you go, Isis. So, yeah, another woman's in. So, yeah, so. Gaming is something we would like to do, but again, it's tiring. So you just come from comics, now we're doing animation. Then you jump to gaming, it's like, that's a lot to do. Remember, you know, there's five characters, and when you build so much, you can do the same. So it will come, but I always say people just be patient with us. We won't ever give you enough rubbish.
Question
at
the back.
At the back of the corner.
What was your favorite character?
Hello, honey.
What was your favourite character?
In All Knightz?
Yeah.
lose friends, you're going to, you know, you'll lose people that you thought were down for you. Not. So, you know, you'll learn while that's going on, but the success comes later on, which is this in my hand. Do you know what I mean? It's me that's able to say, I created that character. I did that. You know, so yeah.
Last question for you.
Back here for quarter to the hour, right? So we'll be back here for quarter to the hour. Have a look at the books, check out the books in the back, you've got some black history books in the back.